If you use Ableton Live for tracks and keys, imagine how cool it would be to be able to press play on one machine, have it automatically start the other machine, and sync with your arrangement so you can jump to a section of the song and pull up the exact keys preset that you need on your other machine. Hey, I'm Will Doggett, Ableton Live certified trainer, founder of From Studio to Stage. Today, I'm gonna show you how to connect two machines running Ableton Live, one for tracks, one for keys, and keep them perfectly in sync. So let's get started. All right, so this is way easier than it sounds to make this happen. And before I get into the details, I wanna address one question up front that I'm pretty sure you're asking, which is why are you not using Link for this? Now, if you're not familiar with Link, Link is built into Ableton Live, I believe starting with Live 9.7 possibly, but it's fairly recent, that makes it really, really simple to sync two machines on the same wired or wireless internet network. It's really, really great if you're doing live performances, especially if you're in more of a electronic band that, you know, someone's playing drums and they're using a laptop, someone's playing bass and their sounds are on a laptop, and you're really performing kind of in the moment and anyone can change the tempo. Super, super cool. Now, the thing I don't like about that for the scenario of using tracks and keys, especially in a band situation, is one, anyone can change the tempo, which we probably don't want. We want it to stay at a consistent tempo. But the bigger thing is Link is not arrangement aware. And by that, I mean, on this machine, let me jump to measure 41 and you'll see this machine jump to measure 41 automatically. I can't do that with Link because again, Link is built for non-linear performance. Anyone can change the tempo and everyone's in sync. But what we're gonna do is do this without Link. And the way we're gonna do this is just simple MIDI sync. Now, the way I could connect the two machines, and again, I'm using two machines in this setup, is either using 5-pin between this audio interface and that audio interface, where I'm gonna send a MIDI cable out of this interface, the tracks machine, into the input of the MIDI on my keys machine. If you're using 5-pin and the machines are close enough, less than 50 feet, I think is the spec for MIDI, then you could do that. But the way I wanna try to do that is with Ethernet. So the way I have these two machines connected is I'm going from this machine to a network switch, out of the network switch into this machine. That's gonna allow me to connect them to other bits of hardware, to plug in a MIDI 4 Plus, my Play Audio 12, get them all on the network. Or you could just literally plug one Ethernet cable from this machine into this machine. And we're gonna use Audio MIDI Setup, which is built into every Mac to make this happen. Super cool, super easy. Now, to go more in depth on how to set up Audio MIDI network between two machines, make sure to watch our video that shows you how to set that up and use that with Ableton Live. But I'll show you really quick. Over on my tracks machine, my Audio MIDI setup, my network is created and I'm connected automatically to this machine. And I'll open this up so you can see the settings. You can see they're both connected. Again, who may connect to me is set to anyone. I have Bonjour names for both of these and participants they're showing in each list. And then now let's talk about how to make the MIDI settings in Ableton Live so that we can sync these two machines. It's incredibly simple to do. So I'm gonna go into preferences on my tracks machine. And that's Command comma if I'm on a Mac. And I'm gonna go to the Link MIDI tab. And all I'm gonna deal with for this machine right now is the output of the MIDI. So I'm gonna go to Output, and under Network Session 1, which is my MIDI output, I wanna enable Track, which is gonna allow me to send MIDI from tracks to this machine. And that's gonna allow me to use a MIDI clip here and send MIDI notes to this machine, which is great. And then I'm gonna enable sync. Sync is the main thing here that's gonna sync our arrangement and send MIDI clock, which is our time information, to this machine. Now, if I wanna send CC values to control this machine, that's where I wanna enable remote also. But for this situation, really sync is all I need, but I'm gonna enable track as well, just to be safe. So I've got preferences on this machine set up. Let's go to our keys machine. So Command comma, again, opening Live's preferences, go to Link MIDI. This time I'm only dealing with the input here, and I'm gonna go to the input for Network Session 1, and I have sync enabled. Now, you notice on this one I enable track. If I wanted to receive the MIDI from those tracks, I would enable track as well too, but I'm gonna leave it off for now. So I just have sync enabled in this situation. So I'm almost perfectly ready to go on this machine. Two other things I did to make this happen. One, once you enable sync on a input, you need to go up here to the upper left-hand corner of the screen and click the external sync button. What that does is that takes transport control away from this machine, puts it in the hands of this machine. Now, the other thing I did is I have this set up so that all my key sounds for this song are loaded into a track. I've got them loaded into an instrument rack, and I'm using chain selector. Check out our video on using instrument racks and chain selector to learn how I did that. And you can see, based on the different types of sounds, I have different chains plugged up. And now, depending on where I am in the song, depends on what preset is loaded. So you can see here's preset 6, and then we jump to preset 7 at that portion of the song. Here's all you have to do to make this happen. I'm gonna press play on this machine, and you'll see transport control play automatically starts on this machine. Super, super easy. Now, if I wanna jump ahead to the section that preset 7 starts, I'm gonna click that locator. It's gonna weigh to measure to the end and down beat of 1. You hear the audio switch here. And then if you look on this machine, you'll see chain selector is set to 7. And again, if I press stop here, then you'll hear this machine stop. One other thing I can do to make this more impressive or to make it clear kind of how it's happening, I'm gonna turn the metronome on this machine and turn the metronome on this machine. And now you'll hear both of the metronomes play at the same time. Let me make sure I got volume up for you. So you hear both of those play perfectly in sync, which is great. And this is really, really cool if one, you're have tracks, your tracks at your drummer station maybe, keyboard players, you're using Ableton Live for keys and you have that over to the right by your keyboards. This is a great way to keep everything perfectly in sync, have your presets change perfectly in time and make it very, very cool. Now let me show you one other thing. Because I enabled track here, I'm gonna go back to this machine and enable track, and I'll show you what else I can do. And this is really, really neat. And then on this machine, let's create a MIDI track, and let's call this machine 1 MIDI, right? And I'm gonna turn the MIDI output to network session 1. I'm gonna enable this track, and then I'm gonna use the computer MIDI keyboard. And let's make sure this guy is turned up. All right, and we have auto, and let me just play a sound here. Now, and you can see I'm playing MIDI notes on this machine. It's being sent over the network, wired network, into this machine to play sound. So what's cool is you could distribute your sounds across machines. If you have maybe your tracks and you wanna stay here and play tracks, but have all your sounds loaded on another machine, you could definitely do that. The other thing you could do is you could have your tracks machine trigger scenes or trigger different things in Ableton Live. Let me show you how easy it is to do that. So I'm gonna create a new track and we'll call this remote trigger. All right, and I'm gonna double click to create a clip here. I'm just gonna use a MIDI note for now. All right, I'm gonna drag this to be one measure. We're gonna do MIDI 2 network session 1. Okay, and then what I wanna do is MIDI map that to something over here in Live. So let's map it to scene 1. So what I'm gonna do is go back into my MIDI settings before I do this. And on under link MIDI, I wanna make sure remote is turned on for input. And what that means is I'm gonna allow this machine to MIDI map to remote control of this machine. It's just like if I had my MIDI controller and I pressed play and it started play on this machine or pressed something and it triggered a scene on this machine. I'm gonna do that from this machine, this tracks machine over Ethernet. So let's try this. So I'm gonna press play. We go to MIDI map mode here and select scene 1. And let's see what happens, okay? So you see that's mapped. C3 is the note that's mapped there. So now what can happen is let's stop all clips. And then I'm going to just trigger this note and we'll see that this first scene here plays. Yeah, you can see that trigger. Here I click start. And again, so what's cool about this, the possibilities are endless. One, our presets will automatically change on our keys machine. Two, our tempos are perfectly in sync. Three, we could use this machine to send MIDI to play key sounds on this machine to distribute our key sounds across multiple machines. Four, we could create MIDI clips that send any type of information and map them to anything on this machine to just have endless possibilities of control. And it's all possible with one Ethernet cable, which is very, very cool. Now to learn more about how to sync machines together, the crazy possibilities of things you can do using Ableton Live on stage, make sure to head to fromstudiotostage.com where you can start a free 7-day trial to experience everything that we have to offer. One, you'll be able to see and have access to every course in the catalog. Two, you'll be able to join the amazing community of performers that are all focused on using Ableton Live, live on stage. And three, you get access to a monthly call that's just for subscribers every single month where you get a chance to ask questions, answer, and I'll be able to show you some of the stuff I'm working on that month. So would love to see you there and would love to see you subscribe. But thank you so much for watching. watching this video and hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye.